Hey guys, it's Adam back with another video, and today I'm going to be doing a top 5 phones under $450. So I'm going to be mentioning the Galaxy A5 that came out in 2017, the LG G5, the OnePlus 3T, the iPhone SE, and the iPhone 6. So without further ado, let's get into it. Okay, so starting off, we have the Samsung Galaxy A5 that came out in 2017. Now, there is a 2016 model of this, but the new one is a lot better, with an IP68 waterproof rating, and, I mean, just look at the design, it looks pretty nice. I'm thinking of getting one myself, but I'll have to look at that further. And it's got a fingerprint sensor, which is very good for the price, only $342. I will link the UK links in the description as well. I just love the look of this design. The phone is just really nice, and it gets pretty good reviews for 3.5 stars. Not the best, actually, if you look at that, but it is a budget phone. It's very good, and I definitely recommend it. So the next phone is the LG G5, and there's a lot of hate from this phone, and people don't like the modular design. And for me, I mean, it doesn't really matter. I mean, I like the modular battery. I think the modular, other things you can get isn't worth it for the price. But for $324 on Amazon, I definitely recommend this. It's still a capable phone of today. And now that LG G6 came out, you can get this for an even cheaper price. And it was already lowered because not many sales were being given. And even though this phone wasn't bought that much, it is a decent phone. It works well. Someone in my family has it. It works completely fine. I definitely recommend it. So the third phone is the OnePlus 3T. And OnePlus is a very good brand for budget phones. And it's got one of the best specs on the market. A new OnePlus 5 is coming out soon. So I will try to get one of those. Probably hard. But this looks very good, and I definitely recommend it. It's got a fingerprint sensor and reversible buttons, so on both the buttons on the phone, instead of having on-screen buttons, you can switch the way the buttons are, the back button and the select app drawer button. It comes with 6 GB of RAM, which is amazing, 64 GB of storage. It doesn't have microSD card expansion, but it's a very good phone. And for $440, I definitely recommend it, even though it's slightly on the pricier side compared to the LG G5 and Samsung Galaxy A5. So the next phone is the iPhone SE from Apple, and this is a different phone. It's quite small, so I only recommend this to a few people. It's got 64 GB of storage, and for £430, you can't go wrong. $430, sorry. But you can get it in pounds as well, for around the same price. Anyway, this is a very good phone, but one downside to it is that small screen. And although it's got a good price for it, it's got live photos and lots of features that the iPhone 6S has, it's not the best. It's quite a small screen, and it's rocking the iPhone 5S's body, which means worse resolution. And the 1.2 megapixel camera isn't that good. Even though the back-facing camera does shoot 4K, that is a good camera for that. Anyway, so on to the last phone, we have the iPhone 6. And this phone is decent. It's 2 generations old, not including the SE. And it's got a good screen, big screen, nice. It has Touch ID, just like all the phones that I've mentioned in this list, but the one problem is it doesn't feature most of the latest stuff like 3D touch and live photos. So it's quite old now. It's not very old, not as old as the iPhone 5S, let's say, but this is a good phone for $450. It comes with 64 GB of storage, and I would recommend getting that 6S if you do have the money. Maybe get a refurbished 6S if you will, but this is still a very good phone if you want a bigger screen, but you want iOS as well. Okay, so before I finish the video, I do want to say some recommended phones for a cheap price, and I recommend the Galaxy A3 if you want a smaller phone, because the Samsung Galaxy A5 is pretty big, bigger than the S7, not the S7 Edge, just the S7, but the A3 is a very good phone. It's got slightly lower specs, but it's still pretty good. I definitely recommend it. It's only got 16GB of storage, but has micro SD card expansion, so I do recommend that. And another phone is the Sony Xperia X Compact. And although this is a decent phone, it's not waterproof like the Z5 Compact. And it's slightly more expensive than the Z5 Compact if you want to buy it now. And I definitely recommend getting the Z5 Compact over this. But this is the latest one, so if you want slightly faster specs, then I do recommend this. But using the Z5 Compact is slightly better because it's waterproof and it shoots 4K and this doesn't. So that is something you have to watch out for when you are buying the Sony Xperia X Compact. Though an XZ Compact may be coming out, I'm not sure, I haven't looked into it, but it might be, and that would maybe lead to waterproofing and 4K video shooting for a slightly higher price. Anyway guys, that is it for the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one.